The next few minutes of our show may very well be called Star Time. And by that I mean Miss Kay Starr.
In this video, I'm going to be showing you how I made this 1950s dress. It was inspired by one of my favourite singers, Kay Starr. She wore it in 1955 on the Taiwan Power Show. And this is the dress. It's in black and white, so I don't really know what colour it is. So I'm just going to guess it was brown. And because I've already got brown fabric, so I'm going to use that instead of buying new fabric. Just reuse, recycle. These, I think I used about 5 metres. 5 metres of that and then a metre of cotton for the mock-up. This is the mock-up here. I made it out of an old bedsheet, literally just the bedsheet I got out of a charity shop. It had red marks on it, like it looked like blood, and it kind of scared me. I hope nobody died on it. Oh, God. Is that a charity shop? Someone probably did. Anyways, that's the pattern for the bodice. What I'm showing you here is I cut the bodice, the front of the bodice, on the seam line of the bedsheet, so I didn't really have to cut it out to separate pieces, but I was showing you that you need to cut it out into separate pieces in order for it to look like the dress. Or you can just make your own version of the dress, it doesn't have to be the exact kind. All that fabric goes into the skirt, that is about 4 metres of faux silk. If you do plan to make this, I would suggest using maybe a little bit more, a thicker fabric, because I used this faux silk fabric and it was really, really thin, like you could see through it, and I didn't know if that was going to be bad. I was going to add a lining layer, but I couldn't be bothered, so I just left it like this. I mean, it doesn't really make any difference. If you're going to wear it a lot, then I suggest adding one. Anyways, this is Sylvia. It does not fit her. Say hello to Sylvia. Hi, Sylvia. Anyway, these are the sleeves. I'll explain what the sleeves are. The sleeves aren't cut on the fold like a normal sleeve. The sleeves are cut as two separate pieces, because if you look at the photo of her sleeves, they've got a section missing where the sleeve would usually be cut on the fold, so it can show a bit of her arm through, and it's got like piping around it, which is actually quite a good design, and then it's sewn in two separate pieces. Like I sewed mine 3 inches apart. I'll show you that when we get to the sleeves, but I'll talk about the cuffs on the bottom of her sleeve. This is the sleeve situation. I'm just kind of sewing on, kind of like bias binding, but it was cut on the straight grain, so it's not bias binding. I don't really know, I'm going to be honest. So I just kind of sewed that down with the machine, and then to hide the stitching so it wasn't like visible top stitching, I hand whipped it down. Just a blanket stitch, just kind of really small. Anyway, this is the sleeves after they're finished. They kind of look the same. I didn't really record myself sewing the cuffs, so this is the best I've got, really. It's just kind of like cut down the middle. It was very hard to sew, it kind of started puckering at the bottom, if you can see that. But use a bit of interfacing if you want it to stick up as much as Kay Starr's does, because it'll kind of like flop down, because it was only made with cotton. That was all I had on hand at the time I was making this. I made this in February. This is me just sewing up the side seam of the skirt and then gathering it all down. Gathering down 4 metres of faux silk was a task, I'm going to be honest, it took me about half an hour. This is the sleeves completed, and I think it just looks so nice. I haven't finished the inside, but I'll need to do that at a later date because I've already took the pictures. This is the collar. The collar was quite straight. I thought the collar would be in three separate pieces, but I could really just cut it out on all the one piece, because I had enough fabric to do so. I thought I wasn't going to have enough. But I measured 6 inches down from the shoulders, and then 4 inches across from the bust, which gave me 10 inches, and then I rounded it off, kind of an air curve. It's kind of like a circle, but it's a really strange shape. It's deeper in the back, but like kind of thicker and like small at the front, because the bowl covers up the front. I think the back might be about 4 inches long, and then the front might be about 1 inch, 1.5. If you have broader shoulders, it's obviously going to be different for you, like, so that's kind of the diagram. You cut it on the fold because it'll just make it so much easier. For the cuffs, I used cotton because that's what I had on hand, but then I found this in that little fabric stash, which was a faux, I think it's Dupioni, I'm sure, I really don't know. It was really thick, it's kind of like satin, but it was a lot thicker and a lot more buffed down than satin. I realised I was going to line this, but then I realised I could just get away with ironing it underneath, like kind of folding it under and then just sewing it down, because it would be so much easier. What I mean by that was on the inside, because I never added a lining layer, I would iron it down, and then the bits that I folded down I would kind of like run and stitch over, which I done in that photo. For the bow, I cut out about, I think it was either a 9 or 8 inch rectangle cut on a fold. You can do it in two separate pieces if you want, but making it on the fold is just a lot easier because you only have to do 2 lines of stitching. So you sew the both ends up and then you just flip it inside out. My machine was broke, so I had to sit and hand sew it all. The rest of the costume was hand sewed because honestly, my machine would not sew a single thread. It kept snapping, it was just really annoying. I'm getting a new one in a few weeks, which is quite good because then I can start sewing again. But in the meantime, I'll just have to hand sew if I want to sew anything. So yeah, sew up the 2 sides, that's what I've done. And then on the other side, I've done a ladder stitch, which I'll show you in the wee diagram. I found it online, and I don't know if it helps or not. You just kind of sew back and forth, kind of like a whip stitch, but almost underneath the fabric in a way. The best thing to do is look at a tutorial online. I'll link one in the description because I don't think my diagram helped. And then you would get a 2 inch strip of leftover fabric, which I just kind of hand stitched down. So gather the bow down in the middle, so it's 4 inches on each side, and just run and stitch it down, and then with that little bit of fabric just kind of put it over the top of it and then sew it down at the back, and then sew on at the front of the bodice, and that's your done. Here she is. Oh my god, it's so cool. Oh shit, I still haven't got that cuff on. Don't look at that arm. Just look at that arm, look how cool. This bit could be a little bit better. Like, instead of a diagonal line, I would rather have it curved. I might take it out because there's still a bit of fabric in there. Like, because I haven't really finished it on the inside. I'm going to add a line in, don't worry. Oh, that's soon enough. But if the 2 bits were more rounded, I think it would look really, really good. It still does look quite good. I'm gonna sew the bow up because the bow's a bit floppy right now. It's kind of just like dripping. But yeah, it's really the back is something. I'm not gonna really bother with the back. You're not gonna see the back of this dress. Don't worry. The sleeves. I've kind of put pins here now. Yeah, I've put pins here now because I'm gonna sew a few stitches there to keep it up, because if I didn't sew stitches in here, I'll try and let this out, I'll try and take the pin out. It just kind of like falls because it's not got any interface in it. I mean, which side would you want there? Would you want that side or would you want this side? Oh no, I can't put the pen back in. Wait, I need pictures and like a wee video of someone wearing it. Because I can't just have it on Sylvia. I mean, Sylvia, you are a great model. We know you're a great model, Sylvia. But we can't just have you wearing it. We need a human. No offense, I'm sorry. You look beautiful. Right. Keep getting your shoes in. I'm gonna have to mute this. Just do stuff in it, like honestly.
If the sun should tumble from the sky, if the sea should suddenly run dry. A dream I build should fall apart, I can still be smiling with my heart. If you love me, really love me, let it happen, darling, I won't.
You just think I'm back.
Vibrant, like see on camera. It's really beautiful in here.